Hi, how many of you have kids who have hurt you very deeply with their nasty words and nasty comments about who you are and what you are and what you are not? Yeah. And what do you do at that point in time? Keep watching, I'll tell you what to do. Okay, I'm Bimal Raj. I'm the founder of my company, training company Orange Talks, and I've been studying parenting for about 20 years. Now, understand that most parents, if not all, have come across these dialogues that you're horrible, you're the worst dad possible, mother, you're a devil. You know, all these kind of things come from people whom we love so deeply and otherwise are extremely sweet, and we completely get taken aback and we reel under that onslaught of all these words. Now understand that the kids have just started, especially teens have just started their life, and they don't have the experience that comes with living, as we call it. Okay, if there is a birthday party and she needs to go for it, and for some reason you can't let her go because of some genuine reasons which you expect her to understand, unfortunately she doesn't. Okay, she only has the understanding of the excitement that is there, but not the understanding of the all other aspects of it. She feels that if she doesn't understand, if she doesn't go for the birthday party, she will lose her friends. She doesn't understand that, you know, as days go by, things does not matter so much. A missed birthday party or a missed gathering does not matter so much. For at that point in time, that becomes the most important thing. It's like a life or death, do or die situation for her. And she reacts in a really, really bad way. Okay, everything is critical for them. And she doesn't understand that she won't lose friends. Now, in that state, it is when, in that emotionally high-strung place where she calls you names, says worst things about you. And unfortunately, most parents react at that point in time. Either shut them down or give them a big lecture about what all you have done for her, and I've just taken you to a party, to a mall last week. How can you be so inconsiderate? And all those things, and everything goes downhill from there. Now, when your child says something really bad, what you need to say or do is nothing. Okay, just wait. Let 5 minutes pass. Let 10 minutes pass and you will see your child back. Okay, she would come down and she will change very, very fast. Their reactions are all momentary, and if we can hold our emotions in control, our anger in control, it will be fine and she will come out of it absolutely fine. What normally happens is that you react to it and then she reacts to it, and then your child takes your reactions personally. Okay, so remember, when something really bad is thrown at you, do not react. You have to show them that you are much more mature and emotionally stable than who they are. And that is how they grow to trust you. That is how they grow to depend on you, knowing that you are there like a rock and you don't lose it the way they do. If you agree to what I said, please comment and like the video, and please share the video. There'll be a lot of parents out there who could be confused or maybe even reacting to what their kids say. Thank you.